We use grids to deal with data, lots of data, and when we deal with data, we often have to perform calculations. Welcome in this new video on the FNC Data Grid that focuses on how you can get the most out of calculations in our FNC Data Grid. We will cover in this video how you can add different kinds of column calculations, row calculations, how you can also introduce your custom calculations into the FNC Data Grid. And finally, we will also have a look at doing calculations on grouped information. And so I find myself in the Delphi 12.2 IDE, and we are going to create a project from scratch so that you can see all the steps involved to get calculations to work in the FNC Data Grid. I've started a new VCL application, and we are going to add the FNC Data Grid on the form. Here is the Data Grid with how it appears as default at design time in the form. And so we are going to fill the grid with data, and we will perform some calculations on the data added. So the first thing that I'm going to do is clear the grid so that the default columns are cleared out or removed. And then I'm also going to add a fixed bottom row to the grid. It is the fixed bottom row where the calculation results will be displayed when I will be using column calculations. What I will also do is add a couple of rows more than the default value by setting them to 50, for example, and then I will fill the grid with some random data. I can do that with the built-in function random fill numbers between 0 and 100. So this is the setup of our grid to show some numbers in it and to get going with calculations. Now we are going to introduce how to add the calculations. And what I'm going to use for that is the column calculations property that I can use. And this property has two parameters. The first one is the column for which to perform this column calculation, and then some kind of ID identifier with which you can at some later time also recover what kind of calculation was added to that column. Notice that this property represents an array of records, and these records will hold all the information that applies to the calculation that is added. And so I create such an record with these calculation specifications, and I can create such a record with the create normal column calculation function that creates for me a record. And as you can see, that has optionally quite a few parameters. The first parameter is the method of calculation, and we'll show it in a moment. Next to it, you also have the calculation options callback, which can be an anonymous method that specifies additional options that are related to that calculation. For example, how the result should be formatted in a cell. Next, we have the column calculations calculation callback itself, which is a callback or anonymous method that can be used to perform custom calculations, so where you can introduce your calculation method yourself. And optionally, also you can specify over what range of cells the calculation should be applied. When you do not use this, when you are as such using the default values, in column calculations, all normal cells within a column are taken in account to perform the calculation. We'll start with the easy way out and just specify the calculation method. And as you can see, there are already a couple of built-in calculation methods, sum, average, maximum, minimum. It can also count to distinct values, or specify a custom calculation. So let's add, for example, in this first column, a sum. And what I will also do is for the second column, I will add an other calculation method. Let's call calculate the average in the second column. So here I add the average, and that should be sufficient to get our calculation going in our grid. Here you see the result, and you can see that the sum of values in this column equals 2408. The average is also calculated and displayed here in the grid. When I now edit a value, you see that this average in this case is not updated, but it's very easy to add the functionality to update this. What I can do for that is implement the after close in place editor, and from this event handler I am calling the update calculations call. And when I do this call, then when I edit something in the grid, you will see that the calculation is automatically updated. And the same actually applies when I would programmatically change values in my grid cells. I could do that from a button, for example. And here I call it update. And in this method, I will just actually recall the random fill method to update the random values. And of course, to have the calculations performed again, I should also from here call the update calculations method. And let's do that. Update column calculations, or overall all calculations in case you have both rows and column calculations added. It will do both. So now when I call update, you can see that both the sum and average are recalculated. What I can also do is introduce custom calculations. And what I have prepared here is a sample that will calculate the root mean square, the squared average, so to speak. And this is the formula to calculate this value this way. I've prepared a code snippet that shows you how you can do that. And this is the example that I have calculated. I will comment it in a moment. I added it this way, so it is applied to column 2. It's the root mean square that is calculated. And as you can see here, I'm also using the create normal column calculation, but here I specify that a custom calculation should be used, and I'm using a couple of anonymous methods. The first one is the anonymous methods that will allow me to override the formatting of the value in this case, my fixed row. And the second anonymous method is a anonymous function that is the actual calculation, in this case, of the root mean square. You can see that the parameters of this function are the column to which this custom calculation applies, and then from what row to what nth row to calculate this root mean square. And you can see this calculation will make the sum of the square values of all cells in this column, and finally it will take the square root of this sum divided by the number of rows in this particular column, and it will return the result here. So when I run this application, this is actually the root mean square value calculated on this column. And when I change this value, you can see obviously that it decreases, expected decrease. When I change values in this column, this root mean square is automatically recalculated. Let's take this to yet another step further, and that is by introducing groups. And what I will do now is just change a little bit the values to make groups that are, let's say, that make sense. And here I will group by column 1. And I will also add an option under options. Options, that is under grouping, and hidden columns is true. That means that the column on which I apply the grouping, that column will not show in the resulting columns after the grouping. So this is invoking the grouping. Now let's add a calculation that applies to this group, and I do it in the following way. Again, with the column calculations, and let's add a sum for the second column of my group. It's same. It's the same concept. An array of possible calculation values, and here I will do create group column calculation of the sum method. I will add it without any further customization as is, and let's see how this turns into a result. As you can see here, I have a grouped grid, so it's grouped by the values in column 1. So I have random values between 0 and 10, so it's normal that I have grouped values by 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. And here you can see for this second column in the groups that in the group bottom row, the sum is calculated and shown here. So this is how easy you can also apply calculations to groups in the FNC data grid. The same applies to row calculations, which are actually accessed or added in a similar way. The grid features the row calculations property, where you can apply this to a specific row and, for example, also introduce the row, the group sum, or better, the sum of this particular row in the grid. A more comprehensive example is ready made, and actually you will find the download link nearby this or under this video, and where you have the full source code of this example. And this is somewhat more elaborated to show you all kinds of capabilities. Here we are inserting from the button click and sum calculation with several options, and where you can see that the sum is actually shown in a nicely formatted way. And the same applies for the average. We calculate the maximum. This is all added via these button clicks, and we also add row calculations. And here you can see that for the row calculations, we have several options. We have the sum, count, minimum, maximum, and so on. And these are inserted obviously via the row columns property. When I run this application, you will see everything applied and in effect. This is my application. And so when I add the column sum, you can see the sum of the first six numbers obviously is 21. The result is shown in this last fixed row. I can calculate the column average. You can also see that the width of this column automatically adapts because we have called also a function after adding this calculation to size the column width to fit all the text in this column. The column maximum can be retrieved when I change this here. When I edit this and change it to 99, you can see that it is also automatically updated. And finally, all the different row calculations are also shown here in the last column of our grid. This is how you can add both column and row calculations to the grid. What I have not covered yet here is you can see here that we have added one calculation via this array of records to a column. But we can add multiple calculations for the same column. By adding multiple records like this, we just add another record. For example, this was for column 3, and we can add just another column where, for example, we will show the minimum. And here we make it min. And what is happening now is that I need to remove this one. That we show two calculated values in the same for the same column, and it is actually this result and this result that are appended to make up the complete value that is shown in the bottom grid cell. So let's have a look at what might be missing here, and obviously that is here. This that should be corrected. Now it runs. And let's have a look when I add this to the grid. Now you can see here that I have two calculated values, the maximum and minimum in this particular column. And I wanted to conclude with combining row and column calculations. That means that when you have calculations for columns and you want to use the result of these column calculations in a row calculation, for example. So here you can see what we did. Here you can see that we actually added, let's just go to the right place in the code. Here you can see that we added for all rows in the grid, that we added row calculations. And what you can see is also that we have added column calculations. Where are our column calculations? This is here under create calculations, and here you can see for the first two columns in the grid that we had have added some calculations. It will become clear when I run this example, and here it is. Here you can see this is the sum of the first column, sum of the second column, and actually this row value is calculated from these two calculated column values. So you can see that you can create calculations that depend on results of other calculations. When I change values here, you can see that this was updated, but also this value was updated based on the results of these two column calculations. And that shows you the power of adding calculations to our FNC data grid. And I invite you to test it out. The sample source code you can download in the link under this video. Go ahead with the trial version of the FNC data grid and stay also tuned to next episodes of the video series on the FNC data grid to show you much more of the power of this grid. So subscribe here to the video subscription in YouTube. And you will be updated, you will be in touch when we have released our next video on the FNC data grid.